Make a date with Rev Dr Ebenezer Markwei at 6 a.m. from Monday to Saturday on Graphic Online via Facebook and YouTube as he expounds on matters of faith.
Graphic Online, truth and accuracy every day.
Hello, this is Rev. Dr. Ebenezer Markwei of Living Streams International, bringing you matters of faith with Graphic Online. And this morning, I'd like to capture my thoughts with the words, company of fools. Company of fools. Oh, Rev. Markwei wants to insult us this morning. No, not at all, not at all. But it's an admonition, it's an exhortation to avoid the company of fools. In 2 Chronicles 10, 8 onwards, the Bible says, you know, Solomon, built the temple, magnificent and all those other things. But after Solomon's death, his son, Rehoboam, took over the affairs of the nation. He took over the reins of the nation. And I'm talking to people in positions of authority and positions of responsibility. And the Bible says when Rehoboam took the reins of the affairs of government, when he took over, then the Bible says the 10 tribes of Israel came to him. There were 12, but 10 came. That was the northern kingdom, came to him. And they told him, the 10 tribes came to him. They said, listen, we have really worked hard under your father. And your father really taxed us. And your father really made our lives very, very difficult. Our economy was in disarray. We were in trouble. Things were very difficult for us. Things were pricey. We worked hard. He taxed us. And our taxes were exorbitant. And all the things. And they said, please lessen our load. It is the cry of citizenry that their lives should become better. It is a mark of good governance when good governance gives the citizen a reprieve from the burden they share. And the people came to Rehoboam and told him that, please, lighten our load for us. Make it easier for us. Make things easier for us. We have been pulverized to powder. We are at our desperate end. And they were telling them, things are hard. Things are difficult. And they said, lessen our load for us. And guess what? Rehoboam then sought counsel. And the counsel he sought, first of all, he asked those who had advised his father, the elderly people, the older generation. He asked them, what shall we do? Or what should I do? And then they gave him a piece of advice. And the advice they gave him was, listen to the people. Listen to the people. And do just what they say. And they will serve you for the rest of your life. Listen to the people, and they'll keep you in power for the rest of their lives. Listen to the people, and they won't rebel. There'll be no insurrection. Listen to the people, and they'll vote for you the next time. Listen to the people. Lessen their load. Then here's the interesting snag in it all. The Bible says Rehoboam then checked out. He went to his friends, his age group. That is his cohorts, the people that he mixes with. Or the people who this thing, young blood and all those other things, fiery blood, feisty blood. And they said, are you going to listen to these fools? Make their work more difficult. They are lazy. That's why they are complaining. Make their work difficult. And say to them that your little finger is thicker than your father's loins. Whereas your father chastised them with whips, you will chastise them with scorpions. So Rehoboam, instead of listening to the elderly generation, listening to wisdom, listening to people who have walked that road with his father, and they know the plight of the citizenry, they know the suffrage of the citizenry, they know the suffering, they know the critical things that affect citizenry. They knew it. And they told him, do it this way. And his friends, his mates, his age group, the young folks, young blood, wanting to bloody their and also mark their name in the walls of for posterity. Here's what they said to him. Tighten the screws on them. Make things more unbearable for them. Make things more difficult for them. Don't mind them. Reject their plea. After all, they are just citizenry. They are nothing. And the Bible said, Rehoboam stood in front of the people and said, my little finger, what are you people saying? My little finger. It's thicker than my father's loins, his waist and his loins. My little finger is thicker than my father's loins. And whereas my father chastised you with whips, I will chastise you with scorpions. Whereas my father made your life unbearable, I will multiply the level of the degree of suffering. I will make it more worse. I will tax you harder. I will do things to make your life difficult for you. And this is what Rehoboam did. And the Bible said there was somebody there called Jeroboam, the son of Nebat. And then he said, what portion have we in David? We are 10 tribes. We don't have a portion in him. He has only 2 tribes. He's sitting on the throne and he's dictating how our life should go. The pace of our pain, the pace of our suffering. He's dictating it. And I said, to your tents, O Israel, this one, we have no portion in him. So 10 tribes broke away. So Israel was divided because Rehoboam kept a company of fools. Now, if you fellowship with a company of fools, they will give you advice that will wreck you and wreck your future and wreck your potential. So they will give you advice that will be a disaster and you pay a price for it. Watch the company that you fellowship with. Watch who you're listening to, because sometimes you might be swimming in the company of fools. And the advice they may give to you may be detrimental to you, to your fellowship, to your job, to every other thing, to your future and the future of your children. What they are doing, the advice they are giving to you, is going to mortgage your future and the future of your generations and posterity after you in disaster. The narrative, your end narrative, is not going to be a good narrative. It's going to be a bad narrative. Company of fools. If we keep them, we pay a price. Don't listen to the company of fools. See you later.